Hi, happy Groundhog Day, everybody. Welcome to another glorious Hump Day Wednesday, February the 2nd, 2022. Today we are going to be in the next God series video. It's been a while since we've done a God video, but it's all about God series video number 34. I just found out the last number. And can you believe that it was not January the 9th? Was the last God video? Whoa. So, but today we're going to be talking about episode 618, part number 1, your Days of Praise, God's Presence in Flood and Flame. Sounds like a good one. Beginning with Isaiah 43, verse 2. So if you're excited about another God series, if you've enjoyed the God series, smash that like button. Comment something you like about the God series. But if you don't like the God series, just comment something. How has your life been since you've been a Christian? So that'll give you a secondary. If you're not going to comment about the series, comment about that. So subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friend, and help me reach that 100 subscriber mark in 2.5 months, because my birthday will be here before you know it. So let's get on the ball, people. Get on the ball. And if anybody knows a way so I can share the channel and videos more, if I can figure out how to share them to Instagram, then I got a lot of followers on there, because I don't follow them back, but hey, got a lot of followers. Got some people I don't know, but a lot of them I get a lot of people say, oh, so-and-so follows you. This one's following you. This one started following you. But how do I get my videos on Instagram? How do I share my YouTube videos on Instagram? Let me know in the comments. That's another part. So maybe if I can get the video shared on there, people will start tuning into my videos. What do? Take these videos and upload them to, upload them over there? The secondary upload? Just so they'll be able to, oh, that was on YouTube. Let's go watch it on YouTube. Let's go subscribe to the channel. We can watch more. I guess I could just upload one video on there and say, you could see this video. I could, in the description, I said, you see this video and many others on my YouTube channel. Go to my bio for the link to my channel. Because I had the link to my YouTube channel on my bio page. So I could do it that way. But I think I put a link on my channel to the other channel too, if I can figure out how to do that too. That'd be one way of getting the other channel. But you could log onto my channel, go up and click the little link, and it'll send you to the other channel as well. But that other channel should be starting up pretty soon. So, but God, it's all about God number 34. God's presence in flood and flame. Isaiah 43:2 we're starting with. So when thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee, and thou, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. Hang on just a second. Probably not gonna get. I'm gonna try to see how far I can go. It says I got 48 minutes left on charge on the battery. So, see how long I can go. So, although the tremendous promise is primarily to be understood in a spiritual sense, which is deliverance through overflowing sorrows and fiery trials, God has demonstrated his ability to fulfill the spiritual aspects of the promise by its miraculous literal fulfillment in the physical realm on special occasions. So the crossing of the Red Sea by the children of Israel is an obvious example of safe passage through deep waters. Also, we have the amazing experience. We also have the amazing experience of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in Nebuchadnezzar's fiery furnace, and it's the most spectacular example of deliverance from burning. So as the three emerged unscathed from the exceeding hot flames, the king was astounded when he saw these men upon whose body the fire had no power, nor was a hair of their head singed, neither were their coats changed, nor the smell of fire had passed on them. Daniel 3:27. And also there was a fourth man with them in the fire. Three went in, four came out. So the entire world once was caused to pass through the flood, and one day must be destroyed by the fire. 2 Peter 3:6-10. But eight souls were saved by water. 1 Peter 3:20, as the flood carried them safely away in Noah's ark from the violent world of antediluvians, and all those truly trusting in Christ will be saved, yet so as by fire. 1 Corinthians 3:15, when he comes again. So these great experiences of the past and promises of the future assure us that God is able to deliver us through the deep waters and burning trials of this present life. Whoops. I dropped my book. Sorry. And lastly, that the trial of your faith, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ. 1 Peter 1:7. So, there you have it. God's presence in the flood and the flame. Some pretty good examples of different points. Are you talking about the flood, and then you're talking about the fiery pits of the furnace with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? Those three went in the fire, come out unscathed. But the fourth, there was a fourth man with them in the fire. But as the three went in, they turned around and Nebuchadnezzar looked in and saw a fourth man. And that was Jesus. But that's all I have for your Wednesday Days of Praise passage. Your Groundhog Day passage. Coming up tomorrow in your first Blessed Thankful Thursday of February, February 3rd, 2022, we're going to be talking about joint heirs with Christ. Beginning with Romans 8:16-17. So stay tuned to that. I'll get that sometime later. Sometime today, on your Wednesday, I'll get to it. Sometime today. So I'll get to the next 2 days, Thursday and Friday, and I'll probably even do Saturdays if I do it just right. I have enough time to do it. So, but coming up at 1 o'clock. In part 2 of 618, of episode 618, your second Devo of your Groundhog Glorious Hump Day Wednesday, for February 2nd, 2022, we're going to be talking about a humble posture from Amy Boucher Pye, derived from Psalm 16. So stay tuned to that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that after 1. So with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and he'll keep you safe in all you say and do in 2022. And until later, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your glorious Hump Day Wednesday morning and Groundhog Day morning. Hopefully the groundhog reports from the groundhog is good. And everything will be good. So, but until later, go. Bye.